So let us start programming with Python. And to start programming, first of all, you need some documentations or tutorials that you can also read, as well as you can also practice side by side. So this is the standard website that you can refer, which is docs.python.org. Just open this website and you will see this kind of page. So as you can see, currently we have Python 3.7, which is a stable release. So in the stable release, you can go to tutorials. These are official tutorials for Python where you can start your tutorial. So we will start with here point number 3, which is informal introduction to Python and using Python as a calculator. So just click on this and you will find this page where they have given an informal introduction to Python as well as how you can use Python as a calculator. Let me show you with the help of examples, as well as we'll take these tutorials side by side, as well as we will also practice the same on this IDLE or development environment for Python, so that you can also learn side by side and you can also read with the help of tutorials. So now I'm going to go to my start menu and I'm going to open my Python. So this is Python 3.7 and let us start with IDLE, which is Python shell. So let me just do it side by side your tutorials. Okay, so as you can see, we are already programming with Python 3.7. That is why we have opened, or we are starting with Python 3.7 tutorials only. We are not starting with Python 2.7. So first of all, as you can see here, you can use Python IDLE or shell as a calculator, which is a very simple thing. You can easily calculate various values here. For example, you can just do addition. So you can do 2 plus 2, which is 4. You can do some mathematical computation. For example, I can do 50 minus 5 multiplied by 6. So it will automatically take care of the precedence. Multiplication is having higher precedence as compared to subtraction. So the result will be 20. I can also use division, but if I do 50 minus 5 multiplied by 6 divide by 4. Now here you can see I'm not using brackets. In this example, they are using bracket, but I'm not using brackets. So if I'm not using bracket, obviously the result will be different, because now the operator precedence and associativity changes. So if they are using brackets, that means they want to calculate this part first, and then whatever the result of this part is, they want to divide it by 4. But here, as you can see, we are not using brackets. So operator precedence and associativity will both come into play in this case, because multiplication and division are having same precedence. So here we'll be having 5 multiplied by 6, which is 30, and 30 divided by 4, which is going to be some value. I'm assuming this value will be somewhere like 7.5 or something, and then we are going to subtract that value with 50. So if you just do it, so the answer will be 42.5. but I can also do opening bracket 50 minus 5 multiplied by 6 divided by 4. Now here the result will be different, because 5 minus 5 multiplied by 6 is 30. So this value will be 30. So 50 minus 30 is 20 divided by 4. So the result will be 5.0. As well as I can also do division. I can do 8 divided by 5, which is as simple 1.6. Now generally, when we do a classical division, for example 8 divided by 5, it is returning a floating point number. If you do, for example, 17 divided by 3, it is again going to return a floating point number, simply like the 17 divided by 3. So it is a floating point number. But if you want a floor value, floor value means if you do 4 divided by 3, the floor value is 1 and the ceiling value is 2. So floor value is the closest minimum, closest integer value. So if you do 17 double divide 3, so here with the help of this double division, I can have a floor value. So here in this floor value, the minimum integer closest value is 5. I mean the closest value which is an integer and which is less than this value. Okay, so the result will be 5. To find out modulus, I can use 17 modulus 3. The result will be 2. As well as I can also use various combinations. For example, here 5 multiplied by 3 plus 2. So obviously you can use it like this. Secondly, if you want to do square, for example, 5 raised to power 2 is going to be 25. So for square purposes or for power purposes, I'm going to use star. I can also use 5 double star 3. So that means 5 raised to power 3, the result will be 125. I can also use 2 double star 7, that is 2 raised to power 7, so which is 128. I can use 2 double star 8, which is going to be 256. So this way you can also use division, you can also use power operator, as well as you can also define some variables. Now remember, in C, C++, Java, .NET, in all these programming languages, you have to define variables. For example, you can say a variable, an integer variable, a variable is a character variable, floating point variable, or whatever type of variable it is. But in case of Python, you do not have to define variable that way. You can just create a variable. For example, I can say w is a variable which is having a value 20. I can say h is a variable which is having a value 10, so which is width and height. So I can also find w multiplied by h, so result will be 200. Okay, now I can also maybe try and create one more variable. We can say x is equal to w multiplied by h, so the value of x if I want to print, so which is 200. So it is very easy. You do not have to actually define a variable the way you define a variable in C and C++. It is just like you just have to assign some values and it will be defined as a variable. But what if you have not defined any variable? For example, here we have defined w, we have defined h, we have defined x, but we have not defined n. If you try to find out the value of n, it will say it is not defined. N is not defined. Okay, the name n is not defined. So to use a variable, you have to define it first of all. Correct? Now you can also do calculation with mixed number. For example, here you can see 4 is an integer, 3.75 is a floating point number, and 1 is an integer number. So you can do calculations like this. You have full support of this kind of mixed calculation in Python 3.7. And there is one more operator, which is underscore operator, which you can use for previous value. Let me show you what do you mean by this. Let us suppose I can say t represents text, which is 12 multiplied by 100. I can also say p, which represents price, maybe it is 1000. I can also do text multiplied by price. So this is the result. Now if I want to use this previous value in the next case, so I can either store this t multiplied by p in a variable, or I can just use underscore. What do I mean to say is, let us suppose I can do 1000 plus an underscore. Underscore means it is going to take this value here. Okay, so if I just press enter, so you can see here this value, here I guess it is 12 lakhs. So 12 lakhs plus 1000, so this is the result. Now I can also have, let us suppose I want to have 1.23456 plus underscore. So in the previous value, this 1.23456 is added. Now I can also round it off to some nearest value. For example, here this is a very big value, so I can also do round. We have a previous value, which is underscore comma 2, that is 2 digits only. So this is the 2 digits, so we can also round off this value to 2 digits. Okay, so I can give some value, or I can use underscore for the previous value only. So this way you can use Python shell as a calculator, which is, as you can see, it is very convenient to define variables here. It is very convenient to perform some simple calculations using this Python shell, and it's very easy, right? Now let us see something about strings. How can you define strings, and what are the operations that you can perform with strings with Python? Okay.